Merry Christmas from all at Myddelton. As we weren't able to host any carol services or Christmas play evenings this year, I've recorded a virtual Christmas celebration concert instead. It includes drama and music and hopefully lots of fun. Enjoy. Backstage at Christmas by the Upper Prep.
You just jealous because you have no kind of wings around. Maybe some Christmas, when you mature like me, you'll be able to handle this responsibility. You'll graduate from knowing sudden danger to be given a few lines of another role.
Yeah, like maybe the innkeeper, all he gets to say is, "No room."
Hey, that's my part. That's an important role. You can pack a lot of emotion into those two words.
Yeah, right. Like the whole play would fall apart if you didn't have the correct intonation.
Hey, knock me all you want. It's my part and I'm going to do it the best I can. You can't have my part.
Now go finish getting your makeup on, there's a good girl. We'll need your angels about 15.
Now
I need Mary and Joseph.
Find Gabriel!
Gabriel! Somebody find Gabriel.
I'm Gabriel. I stand in the presence of God. No, wait, in the very presence of God.
Oh dear, Mary and Joseph.
Traveling minister guy told him he was going to have his wife because I'm having a baby.
Close. Here, stand up. I'll show you. Now, you're Elizabeth, and you be Zechariah.
Oh, right, speaking far. I'll be the angel Gabriel.
Okay, now, you're a priest, right? And you're in the temple offering incense. On the altar.
There's a carpeting?
No, not that kind of altar.
It's kind of like a little stove.
Hey!
pray incense on the altar. Right, now you're an old man and your wife Elizabeth is old too. That's you. You don't have any kids, but you really want some, so you're going to pray for a son. Go ahead.
Oh God, I'm an old priest and I want a son.
Like that?
No. Take your ready here. How would you pray?
Okay. Oh Lord, I know you hear us when we pray. Me and Elizabeth have tried to do what's right all these years. We'd really like to have a son. Amen.
Excellent. Now comes an angel.
That's me.
We'll do your stuff then.
I'm Gabriel. I stand in God's presence.
You stand in his Christmas presence?
Not that kind of presence.
Let me try it again. I am Gabriel. I stand in God's presence. Don't be afraid, Zechariah.
Oh yeah, you're supposed to be afraid.
I am? Okay.
So I ran up to the court, waving through the defenders. I faced left and darted into a lane and went forth the lane, and that tied the game.
Hi Elizabeth, hi Zechariah.
Hi. You know I can't wait till we get to the part where the angel makes this guy shut up.
What? Didn't you want to hear how we won the game? In overtime, I'm at the free throw lane, right where I...
Hey Zechariah, the director's calling for you. You're wanted on stage.
I am?
Man, that guy just goes on and on. What are you guys up to?
We're just going over the play, right here.
Without what?
What are we supposed to be doing again?
You guys are outside praying.
Oh, okay, let's go.
Don't be afraid, Zechariah.
I'm not. Oh, wait. I am.
That's right. God has heard your prayer, and your wife Elizabeth will have a son. His name will be John.
Hey, where'd they go?
You told them to go outside and pray.
What? Oh, man. I'll be right back, guys.
What happens next?
Next, you don't believe Gabriel.
Why don't I believe him?
Because you're old, remember?
People don't believe in angels.
No. You don't think that your wife can have a baby. She's old enough to be a grandma, remember?
Oh well, Gabriel, how can a grandma have a baby?
The hard way?
That's not what I say. Well, God's come to make it happen, whether you believe it or not. But just to show you that God can do all things, you won't be able to talk until it happens.
I won't.
Nope.
So I don't say anything else until the baby's born?
No.
Ooh, I'm going to go practice being silent like a ninja.
I'm the star. I always knew somebody I'd be a star. I was born for the stage. I was made to be wildly popular. Stardom and me go hand in hand. In fact, I'm a superstar, yes.
Not that kind of star. A girl's got a dream, doesn't she?
Don't you feel only glancing like far, far away?
Gee, Queen Elizabeth, if it wasn't for me, the wise men might still be wandering around the desert looking for Jesus.
Hey Elizabeth, we're up, let's go.
Well, I wish I could stay here with you little people, but it's time for the real actress to get to work. Ta-ta! Some people, we may not have many lines, but that does not mean we're insignificant.
So what happens next?
Well, Elizabeth became pregnant with John the Baptist, but before he was born, they weren't married.
Here, you be married.
What, me?
Yeah, but at another Christmas story, you be married.
Awesome.
I am Gabriel. I'm Mary, the highly favoured of God. You're going to be with a child and have a son. His name will be Jesus.
Oh, I know this part. Behold, I've been handmade by the Lord.
No. Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
What's that mean?
She's telling Gabriel that she'll do whatever God wants her to do.
Yep. Gabe, whatever God wants, I'm the girl.
No, come on, this is serious. This was a big thing for Mary to decide. She's saying to God that she's willing for him to create a baby in the womb.
My mum says God creates every baby.
But this is different.
How?
How do I put this?
Let's hear you explain this one. Behold your king! What?
No.
Fanfare?
Well, is it King Horrid?
King Herod! Thank you.
You're welcome.
Are you ready to knock up things by me tonight?
Only if it's you that gets knocked out.
Why? Stand. Are you kidding? You're the one that orders all your soldiers to kill all the kids in Bethlehem just because you wanted Jesus dead.
Hey, it's in the script. If I could do it differently, I would.
Really? Well, we're just at that point now. Let's see how you do.
What do you mean?
We're reenacting the scenes from the play.
Would you care to play yourself?
Why not?
Who are you?
I'm Rachel. I get to weep over my lost children.
You lost your pit.
Should be taxed. Everyone must go to his own home city and register.
So Mary and Joseph travel to Mexico.
I need a Joseph's. Hey, I need a Joseph. You've volunteered.
I have, but I'm a chef.
That you are, but right now I'm for Joseph.
Oh, okay.
So Mary and Joseph travel to Mexico.
And Mary was very pregnant.
Hey, just a concern, won't you?
Are you okay, dear? Let's stop and rest and wash.
Yes, I think that's a good idea. It's getting late.
Oh, look, here's Lynn. Let's see if they have any rooms.
Oh, this is my part. Sorry, sir. No rooms.
No room? What kind of dump are you wanting here?
Joseph wouldn't have said that.
Well, he was tired. He could have been cranky.
Try it again, Joseph.
No room, please, dear. My wife is ready any time to have her baby. Yeah, we need a place to stay.
Sorry, we're full, but I can sign you up as a manger if you'd like.
So we head over to the cold, dark manger, and Jesus is born.
What a lousy way to start a life, eh?
I didn't all in the word about evil. Born in a manger. Died in a box.
But he rose again the third day.
That's right. Do you realise what an amazing moment this was? His birth, here, this is one of the greatest moments in history.
I never really thought about it before. I guess you should take it more seriously.
Yeah, it's like you volunteer to do the Christmas play every year. You have fun playing your part, go home, and it always sinks in what these people actually went through and why.
He could have been born anywhere. He chose to be born in a dirty old manger.
And to die on a dirty old cross.
Okay, places everybody, places. Come on, let's get going. Oh, we're gonna work on the big musical finale. Yes. What is it, Star?
You didn't have to be born in a manger. Why did it happen that way?
What are you on about?
Jesus. With your lot, don't you? And his parents. Do you think they realised how important what they were going to be was?
What are you talking about?
Well, I'm glad they weren't there. Just thought I'd better.
Well, thank you, Star. Come on. Let's get going. Okay. What do they get up to backstage?
Let your heart be light. While the children of the world counted the days before Christmas, the elves of the North Pole counted the sprinkles on their cookies.
397, 398, 399. Aha! I thought it was missing a sprinkle.
Good work, Gimbal. Oh, jingle bells. What am I doing wrong with this gingerbread man? Gimbal, can I get your expert cookie maker opinion?
Whatever I can do to help.
What's wrong with this gingerbread man?
Excellent icing. The Smarties arranged really nicely. The eyes are perfect. Oh, I see the problem. It has no legs.
I'm dashing through the snow. I tell you, Gimbal, when you get that promotion, I don't know what I'm going to do without you by my side.
Well, it's not official. Santa still doesn't know who will fill the new position.
I bet you're going to make the best cookie supervisor the North Pole has ever seen.
Gosh, Macy, I don't think...
Gimbal?
Yes, sir?
As you know, I still haven't decided who should fill in the new position. But I do know, it's work for you! But I would like you to help me with the interview process, to use your expertise.
Yeah, whatever I can do to help.
That's the spirit! Ho, ho, ho! 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 Change your breath bag?
Oh, jingle bells!
Later that day in Santa's office, the first of the interviews begin.
And I've put a lot of hours pulling your sleigh across the sky, landing on billions of rooftops. I figured I'm ready for a change.
And you want to work in a Christmas cookie factory?
Yes. Making delicate, intricately designed cookies with your hooves?
Yes.
You think your hooves can run
roll dough and add gumdrop buttons.
Listen, Gimbal, I might not have fingers, but if I did, imagine what I would be doing with one of them right now.
Prancer! You're a brilliant reindeer, one of the best I've ever had. Why in the name of Kris Kringle would you want to transfer? I'm not feeding you enough carrots.
Santa, it's not you. It's just...
No, dear, you don't have an eggnog problem, do you?
No, Dash is the one with the eggnog problem.
Then why won't you fly my sleigh?
Santa, it's not you. You're the best, jolliest boss a reindeer could ask for.
But what?
That's exactly the problem. Blitzen's butt! I've been flying behind that reindeer for years. And if before that reindeer changes her diet, I'm not going back on that sleigh.
I see. We'll rearrange the order. I'll put you next to... let's see. Which one of those handsome butts that I know you secretly like?
Santa! I think of all my fellow reindeer definitely on a professional level.
Let's see, was it Dasher? Dancer? Comet?
Cupid!
Please put me next to Cupid! Cupid tits.
Just wait till I tell Vixen. She's going to be so jealous!
Well, Gimbal, it seems like these interviews are going to be taking a long time. I'll go throw another new log on the fire. You can send in the next application.
Oh my gosh, is that a new cough? Isolation!
Will the next applicant please come in? Firstly, hey, you old snowman, how have you been?
I'm feeling a little bit just sad. Down the water.
May I take your hat?
Quick again.
Frosty? Frosty, you froze up for some reason. I forgot your magic hat.
Happy birthday!
I had a job interview for the cookie surprise position, remember?
That's right.
So, Lacey, how are you having cake?
I don't have any. How about yours?
My wife left me.
For an average.
Oh dear.
For an average. She got swept away. I miss it so.
Oh, jingle bells.
Happy birthday, where am I? Hi, Flossie. Why don't you sit here? Aunt will be with you in a minute. You just throw me another yule log on the fire.
Oh, probably why you're so hot in my house.
Should I ask him not to?
Nah, it's okay. I will be working close to the cookie thingies, will I?
Well, sometimes.
Is the room getting bigger?
Oh, Frosty, you're shrinking.
Nope, the room's getting bigger.
Oh, Frosty, you're melting.
No. No, it's okay.
I'll stay. All right, who's next?
Glenn doesn't like the smell of this Christmas. It smells of cinnamon and candy.
You know, don't think I've seen you here before.
Glenn dwells down deep down in the deep dark belly of the earth.
Oh, the mail room. So I've looked at your resume, which looks like a piece of bark and fish paste. And I'm not sure you'd be quite right for the job. Do you like meeting new people?
Eat new people? Oh, yes, my precious. Yes, maybe.
Greetings, Santa Claus. My name is Gabriel, Elf Princess Warrior.
Now that's the sort of elf I'm talking about. Look at those muscles. And the amount of cookie dough that could be wrong. Look at those keen eyes that are great for inspecting. Cookie dough, snickerdoodle, sugar plums, and gingerbread man, you're hired!
My apologies, Santa. I've come here to catch this little creature.
Don't let them take
We're in the wardroom. Hopefully the next applicant doesn't ruin this one as well.
So, there's someone who insists on seeing you. I tried to tell them how busy you are, but...
Ebenezer Scrooge.
Well, well, well. One and only jolly old St. Nicholas. So, this is your elf-driven sweatshop I've heard so much about. I hope I'm not interrupting your plans to give away all those free toys from all these little moochers and looters. Bah, humbug.
What do you want to, Scrooge?
I'm here for the job.
Are you serious?
Yes, I'm interested in taking the position of the cookie supervisor.
What? Do you really like making cookies?
Of course not. I've never touched those crummy little things. It's like death covered with frosting.
But I know how to supervise. Under my supervision, your elves work harder than they ever have before.
Well, that sounds all well and good. So all of my employees need to be filled with the holiday cheer.
Filled with holiday cheer? Is that some of Beveridge?
All of my workers should be happy.
Happy at work?
Yes. Even the supervisors are happy and smiling.
I can smile.
Like this, Mr. Scrooge?
No, I still can't do it. I guess that means I failed the interview. I'll never be an Oompa Loompa.
You mean elf?
Whatever.
Don't understand, Scrooge. I thought you were visited by those three ghosts and that you finally learned the Christmas spirit.
Oh yes, that's true. And this is wonderful, but I was so filled up with holiday cheer and wine, and that I signed 51% over a company over to Bob Cratchit and his family. So now they have the control of my company. Now I work for them. Isn't that dreadful?
But Bob Cratchit seems like a fair and kind man.
Oh, it's not Bob Cratchit that scares me.
Where is Mr. Scrooge?
Oh no, it's Tiny Tim! Save me!
You were supposed to be in the office an hour ago.
Oh no, I'm sorry, sir. Please forgive me.
Tim?
Santa?
We better put him on the naughty list.
Yes, Santa.
Where's Jimbo? I thought he would be out of isolation by now.
I'm out of ice, Alicia.
Oh, Gimble, don't milk it. I've already made that joke.
Thank God it's been crazy.
Well, Gimble, you've had quite a time.
Yes, sir. Should I send the next applicant in?
No, I've seen enough. I know exactly who I want to be my next cookie supervisor for the dessert department.
Gimble?
Yes?
Your friend Macy will now be the supervisor.
Really?
Definitely. I like your smile, kid. You've got the right attitude for the job.
Well, Macy, I couldn't think of a better person to be my boss.
That's nice of you to say, Gimble. But I'm afraid you won't be working in the cookie floor anymore.
I won't be working? What the fa-la-la-la-la? You firing me after all I've done at the North Pole? Fine, good. Maybe I'll just work for the goblins. But before I go, there's something I have to say. You're the most...
I'm promoting you to Vice President.
The most lovable boss in the whole world.
Yes, of course. I want you to take care of all of the cookies and the candy canes and the hard cocoa. You've got to keep these delicious desserts going. So you can make sure these elves are happy toy makers. Is that all right with your supervisor, Mason?
Sure is, Vice President Gimble. Gosh, this is going to be the best holiday ever!
There's only one thing that I can think that will make this even better.
What's that?
Mistletoe!
Thank you.
Let me tell you about the most amazing story of the King of All Kings. It all started right here in Nazareth. This is Mary. Little does she know that she is about to become the most famous mother of all time.
Joseph will be so surprised. I hope the angel was right.
Hi, Mary. What's that strange light?
It was an angel, and she told me that I was pregnant.
What?
With God's son.
What are you talking about?
He's going to be the King of All Kings.
Are you telling the truth?
Yes, and I'm pretty shocked.
Don't worry, I'll look after you.
Meanwhile, in the royal palace.
Your Highness.
Yes.
I foresee in the stars there will be another king born soon, and he will be the King of All Kings.
But I'm the king! Where is this king meant to be born?
I do not know, Your Highness, but it will be soon.
Fine! I will order a new poll and tax everyone. Then I'll find this baby.
Thankful to the donkey, Mary and Joseph have made it to Bethlehem, but all of the inns are full.
Sorry, Mary, I didn't think it would be just hard to find an inn. How are you feeling?
I'm really tired, and I think the baby's coming soon.
In that case, we better hurry up then.
Can I help you?
We really need a room, please.
Sorry, but we're full.
My wife is about to give birth to our child.
Please, sir, I really need a room to rest.
But I do have a stable at the back, and it's dry and warm.
Thank you so much.
You are the kind innkeeper.
Mary is holding the baby Jesus after giving birth. She is tired but happy.
Congratulations.
Well done, Mary. You were great. Welcome to the world, little boy.
What's his name?
Jesus. Welcome to the world, Jesus. This is the moment I foretold the birth of Jesus Christ, King of All Kings.
The Good Shepherd is watching over his flock of sheep. When suddenly...
Do not be afraid, Good Shepherd. I am a messenger from God. His son, Jesus Christ, has been born in a stable in Bethlehem. Go to them.
From God? But I'm just a shepherd. Why does he want me to see his newborn son?
Because you are a good man, and he's the King of All Kings for every woman, man, and child.
Wow, okay. But I've already got sheep. Hopefully the death will be alright if the angel is true.
King Herod has heard that baby Jesus has been born in Bethlehem and is not happy.
I am the only true king. There are no others. I will order my guards to kill this baby. I am the only true king.
Far away from the city, an astronomer and philosopher is gazing at the stars.
What star is this? I haven't seen this star before on any of my star charts. Look, it is moving. It's the most special star.
I am indeed a special star to mark the birthplace of Jesus Christ. So I led the wise man to the stable.
I was right. The King of Kings has been born. Please accept my gifts, gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
My goodness, that's very kind of you.
Yes. Thank you. Well, my son, you are truly the King of All Kings.
These are the people who gathered at the birth of Jesus Christ, not knowing but hoping that the wonderful things he would do.
sleigh bells ring. Are you listening? In the lane, snow is glistening. A beautiful sight. We're happy tonight. Walking in the winter wonderland. Thank you.